What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over how to set a seed on your Rust server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. When playing on your Rust server, like any game, eventually you might find that your world is boring. And there's nothing wrong with that. Everyone gets bored after doing the same thing for so long. But after playing for long enough, you might want to restart with a new world to bring a fresh, new, and unknown experience to your gameplay. Luckily, Rust gives you the option to have a custom seed, allowing you to generate either a random world or select a pre-existing one. Let's see how easy it is to do so you can start a new world today. There are a couple different ways to decide on a seed for your server. Whether you enter a random seed or find one online, they will all give you a different result. One way is to use the Just Wiped website, which we will have linked below. Visit the Just Wiped website and search for the map that you want to use using the filters. Once you find your desired map, click on it to enter a detailed view. On the right-hand side, make a note of the size and seed, and when those are written down, you can start to configure your world. To find a seed using playrust.io, visit the playrust.io website. Use the filters at the top of the page to sort through the possible seeds, and once you find the map that you want, select the image to open a more detailed view. On the top left of the page, make a note of the size and seed, and when these are written down, you can start to configure. Head to your Apex server panel and stop the server. Find the Customizations tab on the left-hand side and click on it. In the World Size field, enter the world size from what you wrote down earlier. I will be using the second example today. Then in the World Seed field, enter the world seed that you wrote down. Changes save automatically, and you can return to the main panel page and scroll down to the World section. Press the Change World button, enter a new name for your world, and then restart the server. Your server will now start up with the desired world seed. Now let's go over some common issues. If your world did not change, make sure that the details have been entered correctly in the Customizations tab. Afterwards, return to the main panel page, press Change World, make sure to enter a new, unique name, and then restart the server again. If your world did change, but the seed is wrong, go back into the Customizations tab and make sure that what is filled out in the World Size and Seed section matches perfectly to the one that you wrote down earlier. Depending on the world seed, the size must be a specific value. If the world seed is set with the incorrect size, a different world is going to be generated. Once you are sure that they're correct, head back into the main panel page, make sure to change the world name, and restart the server one more time. As humans, we get bored easily. And that's why in this day and age, games are prepared for that. Rust knows this, and that's why they make it so simple to change your world seed whenever you feel like you need something new. Take a look through either of the websites we talked about today, and you'll never run out of options. That's it for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.